Hi there, I'm Ami Mandavia and I am from ImproX. You know, there are a lot of students who get graduated and they are on the verge of entering the corporate world, and the first thing what they come across are interviews. And you know, the HR has a typical one common question in their questionnaire: what are your strengths and what are your weaknesses? Now, when you address this question, the list of weaknesses, you are clear about it. You have got a long list about it. But when you actually talk about your strengths, you hardly can talk about it, right? You can actually count it on your fingertips, 2, 3, 4 strengths, right? And what the HR is looking for, a long list of strengths and a short list of weaknesses. Now, that is a conflict that we come across, and I'm sure you must have also experienced the same. Now, one thing what I want to actually address in this video is how to identify your strengths. You know, understand something. Success is actually achieved by developing your strengths and eliminating your weaknesses. But what do? We're putting so much effort in actually eliminating our weaknesses, and we don't even put half the effort in developing our strength. Why? Because we more or less don't even know what our strengths are. What is that one thing that you can channelize to grow to achieve that success? Understand, strengths are your force multiplier. Strengths are your springboard to success. Strength is an activity which takes you in you. You know, it just embraces you. It just envelopes you into it so much that you lose yourself, that you lose the sense of time, and you just enjoy doing that work. You know, Marcus Buckingham describes strength as an activity which energizes you, which gives you a lot of happiness, which gives you a different kind of feeling, wherein you know you immerse yourself so much into that activity that you lose the sense of time, you lose the sense of you're so much into that present moment that in fact you get immersed into it, you know, and time flies and you have no idea of who is around. Everything around you disappears. You know, you don't struggle. You know, you're just excited about it even before it begins, because that is what you love, because that is your strength. You exactly know you can do it. You are so clear about it that yes, this is what I want to do, and this is I love, and I can do it. You have that different level of confidence when you're actually getting into it, and you feel so connected and you feel so authentic about it, because that is who you really are. You know, you actually get a platform to play, to explore, and explore your creativity, explore your inner strengths, explore a different you. You know, you discover a different you when you're playing in that playground of creativity, and that is what strengths are. But the irony is that we don't know how to identify our strengths, or rather, let me put it like this: we know our strengths, but we exactly don't know how to put it at use so that we grow, we achieve that success. Of course, in the next video I will share with you how to put your strengths at use, but today what we are going to do is identify your strength. So there are three simple steps that you are supposed to do. The first step is choose 10 people from your life, from your inner circle, who you know will be very honest with you when you ask them a question or when you ask a feedback for yourself. Make sure to choose these people from different walks of life. It can be family, peers, subordinates, your boss, your mentor, or your friend's father if he knows you well. Choose 10 people. The second thing is ask them to give an honest feedback on 3 instances where they witnessed you at your best. So, you know, probably there can be some instance where somebody witnessed that, you know, you never gave up. You fought, you're a fighter, you're a warrior, you're jovial, you're honest, you know, you're resilient. So it can be any of these, okay? So get that feedback. Analyze those feedback, and what you're supposed to do is filter out the common patterns from that, okay? What are those qualities or what are those strengths? Among the whole feedback that you see is common. Pick that out, make a list. The third step is make a self-portrait of it. Make a self-portrait incorporating all those strengths of it. If you're creative, you can use a pictorial view of you and you know having all those strengths in you, or you can at least write a paragraph incorporating all those strengths, like, you know, I am resilient, and because I am resilient, I never give up in my life, and this is what I can achieve. I started my business because I am resilient, right? Something like that for yourself. A paragraph, a description of you which incorporates all the strengths. Now, from this video to the next video, when I teach you or when I tell you how to put your strengths to use, let all this sink. Complete the exercise, let all of it sink. Now, if you have any questions about this exercise, put down in the comment box. Any questions, any queries, any doubts, put that in the comment box. If you have any other questions that you want me to address on this platform, please put those questions also on the comment box. If it is a question which is really going to be, you know, universally needs to be addressed, we can actually shoot a small video on it and we can also put it on the platform. But make sure to address your questions. Get your questions answered, right? So take care. Be happy identifying yourself. Be happy in the journey of your discovery. And all the best. Bye-bye.